In this problem, we're revolving the curve y equals natural log x on the interval 1 to e, and we're revolving that around the x-axis to obtain a solid of revolution. We want to use the disk method to find the volume of this thing, and it turns out that requires integration by parts. So in the graphic, we already have a picture of what one of these disks would look like, and we want to find an expression for the incremental volume contributed by this disk, and that's just area times thickness, and the area depends on the radius of it. Well, for some arbitrary location x, the radius of this disk is just the natural log of x, and then the thickness is dx. So we find our incremental volume. I'm going to call that dv. That's pi times radius squared, so pi times the natural log function squared. That gives me the area of the circle, and then multiplied by the thickness, dx. To find the total volume, we just add up all the volume contributions. That's what integration does. So we have the integral of dv, and if I plug in the definition of dv, I'm going to pull the factor of pi out in front. I have pi times the integral of natural log all squared dx, and we're adding all these disks up as x goes all the way from a lower bound of 1 to an upper bound of e. Now this integral of the natural log function squared, that's where we have to use integration by parts. And I'm going to let u be equal to the natural log of x all squared. And the motivation behind this is that I see this is going to create a simpler function. The derivative of this is going to knock down the power on the natural log function, so I end up with 2 natural log x. The chain rule requires that I tack on a 1 over x. But this is a much better function than what I started with, because the natural log is only raised to the first power, and the 1 over x piece, that's just a straightforward rational function. The other part of the integral is what we call dv, and the only other part of the integral that's left is dx. Now I do have to remember to carry my factor of pi at the next step as well. And I find that v is equal to x. We apply the integration by parts formula, and I start with a u times v. That's x times natural log of x all squared, evaluated on the interval 1 to e. And again, there's a pi out in front of this whole thing. And then I have minus the integral of v du. So the integral from 1 to e of x times 2 natural log x times 1 over x dx. And those x's are going to cancel. Before I write the next step, I'm going to go ahead and evaluate across the limits of integration in this first term. And I notice immediately when I plug in the lower limit of 1, the natural log of 1 is 0. So that part vanishes. When I plug in the upper limit of e, the natural log of e is 1. And then when I replace x with e, I just get an e. And then my leftover integral, I'll go ahead and pull a 2 out in front of it. So I have minus 2 times the integral from 1 to e of natural log x dx. And the integral of natural log x, in order to get this formula, you actually have to use integration by parts again. But my intent in this problem was just that you would have that formula memorized. So the integral of natural log x turns out to be x natural log x minus x. And I need to evaluate that from 1 to e. When I plug in the upper limit, I get e natural log of e. And again, the natural log of e is just 1, so I have an e there. And then plugging in the e to the second term, I get a minus e. So those are going to cancel out. And then I subtract what I get from plugging in the lower limit, which is 1 natural log 1, well, the natural log of 1 is 0, minus a 1. So again, e minus e, those cancel out. And then I have a negative negative 1, so those minus signs cancel out. And I end up with an e minus 2 times 1, or e minus 2 inside these brackets. And we get a final volume for the solid of revolution of pi times the quantity e minus 2. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.